How confident were you that the Dodgers were going to close this out when Dave Roberts went to Clayton Kershaw?
I'd say pretty confident, but obviously everyone knows Clayton Kershaw's history, and it's not a pretty one in the postseason. So when he gets out of me in there on three pitches, you're thinking, okay, the Dodgers, this might be the Dodgers' night. And then he comes back out there to face an MVP candidate in Anthony Rendon, and two pitches later, it's a 1-1 game, and a pitch later, it's a tie game. So it happened also. It happened so quickly that it's pretty stunning just how it happened, just how quickly it happened. And then obviously you go into the 10th inning and Joe Kelly gives up the grand slam. Just the way it happened last night, it was stunning. Just a team that won 106 games to lose that way, it was just a shock to pretty much everyone there.
We knew that the bullpen was vulnerable. And I know that we're a results-based sports society here, Jorge, but, the Nationals had to dance around their bullpen as well and try to close out games here. But, why are the Dodgers not playing anymore?
It's funny because the entire series, the strategy everyone talked about was the Dodgers win this series by waiting out the National starters and getting to the bullpen. And last night, the opposite happened. Mm-hmm. It just seemed like Dave Roberts didn't trust some guys down there. He seemed like he made a couple of wrong decisions. I know, as you said, it's all hindsight's 2020. We can, blame the manager. And I'm not one to sort of go into all that. But, some of the decisions last night, a couple of them, in the moment, you kind of were just wondering, what's this thinking here? What's the sort of the thought process going on? And, keeping Clayton Kershaw in there to face Rendon and Soto and, Kershaw has a great history, obviously one of the greatest pitchers of maybe the greatest pitcher of his generation, a future Hall of Famer, but he's had trouble giving up home runs this season. He's not the same pitcher. He's proven it the entire year. And then you're facing Anthony Rendon and Juan Soto, by far the two best hitters in that lineup. That's a sort of a tough stretch there. And then going with Joe Kelly, for a second inning after he had not gone more than one inning since August, he's been erratic all season long. You got Juan Soto. You intentionally walk Juan Soto with first base open with Adam Kolarik, who had got him out three times in the series, waiting in the bullpen. It's just all kind of, head scratching.
Yeah, that move there, that last one you talked about, that was the one that I thought we were going to see.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV. Stream for free on BR Live or download the Dan Patrick Show app.